Okay, hey everybody, welcome to the Thursday night team call. I'm super excited to see all your smiling faces tonight. Let's see them, right? We have a special guest tonight on our team call, and I will introduce her here in a second, right before we invite her to share with us some tips on what she's done with her business. She has a pretty cool story, so we're excited to hear from her. But first of all, let's talk about Summit. It's like 10 weeks away. I know. Is that Erica up there? Erica gave us the fist in the air. Summit. Summit's going to be absolutely amazing. If you haven't been to Summit yet, it's something you want to do. Whatever you can do, whatever it takes to get there. I know in the beginning when I was first a coach, I didn't know if I could go to Summit because I thought maybe you had to be a certain rank or it was for advanced coaches. You know, I just really didn't know. But Summit is absolutely for every single person that wants to build their business. As you guys know, we had Carl Deichler on the team call Monday night with us, and he was talking about, he kind of made a joke about it, but he's like, if I was a brand new coach and I was struggling and I wanted to build this business and I didn't have the funds or it was sold out, I would show up in Nashville and I would sneak through the exit sign and I would be there at Summit and I would find a way to get in there from the CEO himself. So that shows you how important he shares with us that it is for you guys as well. I know it's important in my life. It's something that I want to make sure that I'm always at and that I talk about going to. If you guys know, here's this book, GoPro. I went to the GoPro seminar, and one of the main focuses they talked about was the importance of promoting events. Our job as a coach or a distributor for any company is to promote events and get people to events. So Summit is something that you want to make sure that you get to and that you bring your coaches to. I know that our business is like it is now because I went to Summit my first year and I brought 50 coaches with me. Every coach that we could gather up, we said, let's go. And it was only like 12 hours away. And many of us carpooled, some of us flew, but we all went to Summit. And I know that played a huge role in my business because it wasn't just this online thing, right? Or these little video chats. It became real for each one of those coaches as they were, you know, in an audience with the live trainers, working out with Sean T, working out with Tony Horton, working out with, you know, every other coach that was there. And I'll tell you one thing that being at Coach Summit will do, aside from the fact that Simon Sinek's going to be there, the author of a couple of my favorite books, like, I hope this is the book. Not that one. My favorite book, Start With Why, by Simon Sinek. He's going to be a keynote speaker there. And we're also going to have many other amazing speakers. There's going to be awesome trainings from top coaches in the company. And they want to teach you what they're doing and what's working for them. So you want to be there for that. But I'll tell you what's going to happen. If you go to Summit, like every single, as you're being consistent on Facebook with your 3 to 5 posts a day, and you're doing your 3 vital behaviors, and you're inviting people, what's going to happen is, like we know, most of these people right now are not going to be joining you right away. They're going to be telling you no, or maybe later, you know, and because everybody we know joins on their own timing. Like for me, it took 8 months for me to join. Many of my coaches, my personal sponsor coaches on here, it took them months and some of them years before they joined as well. But what's going to happen is all these people that you're inviting is when you're at Summit and you're posting pictures of 25,000 people working out, or you're posting pictures at these events, people are going to see that, and they're going to see that this is not just some weird online thing that you're doing, right? They're going to see that this is a real thing with real people and a real company changing real lives. So all these invites you make for the next 10 weeks, when you get to Summit, all these no's and people that are not sure about it and they're just watching you quietly behind the scenes are going to see that you're serious about this business and then take you more serious as well. So we want you guys there. We still have rooms available at the Embassy Suites. Michael Greenberg and I and Jennifer Greenberg, we got 150 rooms and they're almost all booked up. So we have our whole team at one hotel, which is going to be awesome as well. So that when the event's all over, we can all hang out in the lobby and spend time together as well, getting to know you guys as well in that aspect. So we want to see you guys there. So if you haven't thought about going yet, I want you to seriously think about it. And if you have questions, reach out to me or your coach and get some more details. We could figure out how to get you there. Figure out how to split rooms with other people if you guys need it. Get you on somebody's couch or something. Those are the coolest stories about this business is when you do that. You know, I remember, was it Carolina, your group? Didn't you guys have some people in the bathtub with a sleeping bag or something? It must have been someone from Idaho Falls. I remember that. But anyway, we want you guys there. I know many of my coaches saw that when they got bold about what they're doing with this business, went to Super Saturday and talked about it. People began to take them more serious. I know Marquita on here, I gave her a little shout out on our team page. She made a video after Super Saturday, and she started talking about the business on Facebook, and people are interested, and she realized that no's are not so bad, and she's having fun with it now. So, you know, and that all sparked and changed. I'm pretty sure that we can key that back to her going to Super Saturday to an event. So we want you guys at Super Saturday, and, you know, always, like always, on these team calls and inviting people to be on these team calls with us. So there's my summit input. Raise your hand if you think I'm serious about summit. Boom. When we're seriously in our entire team, we're going to have about 800 people at summit this year. With all the incredible leaders we have on our team, we already have about 800 there. So that's incredible that we have about 800 out of the 25,000. So, but we want more. We want 1,000, right? Okay. Well, what I want to talk about is Gina just commented something on here about, is that the Success Club party? Yes. We want you at the Success Club party as well. If you are coming to Summit, and it's a little bit aggressive for some of you guys I know that are hitting Success Club 5 monthly, but if you have 25 points between May and June, you get to go to the Success Club party. And I'll tell you what, Beachbody knows how to throw a party. I remember my first summit. I'll just tell you guys, like, I've never been to anything like a Beachbody event before Beachbody came into my life. And there were, like, mermaids and people, like, spinning in a ball in the pool and all kinds of stuff I'd never seen before. So it's a really cool experience hanging out with, you know, the top coaches in the company. Carl's hanging out there, Michael Neiman, Jeff Hill, all the leaders are there, and for you to meet and mingle with them. So give everything you have and make that a goal for you to be able to get there and do that. So with that being said, I want to turn the time over to, you guys get to hear from me enough, right? We want to hear from Catherine. I'm going to share just a little bit about her. She's been a coach for 10 months, okay? 10 months now. She became a diamond in 11 days. So 11 days, that's 1-1. That's less than 2 weeks. And she became a two-star diamond at day 56, which means she had two other diamond coaches out of her personally sponsored coaches within 56 days. She is now a four-star diamond in her first business center and two-star qualifying in her second business center. And she has hit Success Club 20 plus every month since she began as a coach, which was 10 months ago. So I was like, when I heard about this, I was like, we have to have her tell us what she's doing. What is it about her that is creating this type of success in her team? Because I'm always willing to grow and learn, and I want to expose you guys to people that will empower and help you guys take your businesses to the next level. So that being said, Catherine, I'm going to turn the time over to you.
Okay, great. Thank you guys so much for letting me be here. I'm so excited to talk to you all. So let me just start off by just telling you a little bit about myself and how I got here, and then how I was able to move so fast in this business. So I have two kids at home right now. I have a 2.5-year-old son, Landon, and I have a 1-year-old daughter, Kirsten, and I stay at home with them right now. Before this, I was an elementary school teacher for 8 years. I had my master's degree in special education, and the town I was teaching in had a really good, you know, pay at that point when I was getting ready to leave to stay at home with my son. I always wanted to be a stay-at-home mom with the kids. You know, me and my husband were totally on, you know, on board with that. We were both raised that way. So this was something that we felt really strongly about, is that when we had kids, I was going to stay at home with them. So I got pregnant. I had Landon. I handed in my paperwork and, you know, left my position teaching. And so we took a big hit, you know, when I left that position, like I said, because I, you know, I was making pretty good money at that time. And, you know, even my husband, he has a really great job too. He makes six figures. We knew things were going to be tight and we knew that we were going to have to make a lot of sacrifices, but we were willing to do whatever we could to make this work so that I could stay at home with them. So my husband was doing, you know, his job every day. He was doing videography and photography on the side. He owns a website designing company. He does a skiing forum. I was doing tutoring like four nights a week just to try to make a little bit extra money. And guys, we were still just scraping by. We literally kept getting just further and further into debt. And we basically were just living in a world of denial, you know, in our financial world. Like we just put our heads in the sand and just didn't want to deal with it. Every now and then my husband would be like, Kathy, you're probably going to have to go back to work. And I'm like, psh, no way. Like we're fine. You know, we clearly were not fine. It was horrifying the way we were going. And then all of a sudden Landon's 10 months at this point now, and we find out that I'm pregnant with Kirsten and we really want to have a big family if we can, you know, I'd love to have four kids eventually down the road, but we were instantly just panicked about this because we were thinking, all right, if we can barely make this work now with one, how the heck are we going to make ends meet now with two? And I was on my husband's health insurance at this point and his insurance just really sucked big time. And we were going to be having to pay like $6,000 to have, you know, this next baby. So we were just freaking out. So, again, just kept getting further and further into debt and things were getting really bad for us. I had Kirsten and then right around when she was like 4 months old was when my husband was like, you know, Kathy, you know, and he said it like dead serious, you know, this is it. You know, you're going to have to go back to work. You're going to have to start looking. There's no way out of this. I mean, I'm doing everything I can. You're tutoring. It's just not going to happen anymore. And so for me at that point, I mean, not everyone, you know, it's not for everyone to be a stay-at-home parent, you know, but for me it was. And that's always been my dream, like I said. So when he said that to me, it was literally like someone just like reached in and just ripped my heart right out. Just having to think about now I have to leave the kids and go back to work and put them in daycare after being with them now, being home for like two full years. Like something had to happen. So right around this point now was when my coach brought up the coaching opportunity to me. And my husband and I had actually done P90X like 6 years ago. And we were like walking infomercials for it because we loved it so much. We haven't stepped foot in a gym in like 6 years. We saw awesome results. We were in an infomercial for it, you know. But still, when she brought up coaching to me, I was skeptical. And my husband, you know, being the big business guy that he is, he was like really skeptical. I mean, I'm talking like, you know, he's German and he's very thick-headed and stubborn. And he knows all about this. And he's like, you know, pyramid scheme, like total scam, you know, everything that you hear people say. So it took me like probably a good 3 months. And it was like, that was it. I was at the very end of the line. You know, I actually saw the videos from it. Vegas. So it was that in combination with me like having to go back to work that made me finally like jump on board. And my husband, you know, said to me, all right, Kathy, this is it. You know, let's be realistic here. You have 1 or 2 months to make a little bit of money here. If you don't make money, you're going to have to quit. That's just the bottom line. You know, we cannot afford this, period. And so just a couple things about me is, you know, number one, like there's no way I am not a quitter. You know, that's one thing my parents always taught me is if I start something, you know, you're going to finish it. Number two, I really like to prove people wrong. So I really wanted to prove my husband wrong that I could do this. And number three, I really was like totally desperate to do whatever I could do to make this work so that I did not have to leave the kids and go back to work. So when I started out, I literally had no idea what the heck to do. I remember saying to my coach, all right, like the night I signed up, I'm like, okay, so this is great. This is so exciting. You know, I've always loved being on teams. I love helping people. That's why I was teaching. Like, this will be good. What do I do now? And she's like, well, you just kind of like lay low the next week, you know, don't expect much to happen. And I'm thinking, no way. Like, I don't have time to lay low. I have to run with this now. So I didn't even have my stuff. My stuff hadn't even arrived, guys. And I was 30 pounds heavier than I am now. I was carrying around a lot of extra like baby weight. I could not lose it. Everyone basically told me, you know, you're going to be like that forever. Now that you had kids, just accept it. And I kind of did just accept it for a while. So I hadn't even had anything yet, hadn't even arrived. And I was like, I'm not waiting. And I just literally started messaging like every single person I knew that I could think of that would maybe want to be get healthy and do this 21-day challenge with me and help hold me accountable, and we can do this together. I only had like 320 friends at the time, so it's not like I had a huge market of people to work from. And I didn't even know what a challenge group was, guys, at that point. I seriously didn't. I had heard people say challenge group, and I was inviting people to join my challenge group, but I had no idea what the heck it even was. And next thing you know, I had like 10 people that said they wanted to join me. So that was pretty funny. So I got all these people to join me. And, you know, so people ask, like, how did you do this so fast? And I think, like, you know, and I've been asked to, you know, talk on actually a lot of team calls, and I was talking at my last Super Saturday in Boston about this and everything. And really, I mean, the biggest thing for me was that right from the beginning, I had that really clear cut and really powerful why. So it was never like a question in the back of my mind, like why I was doing this. I knew it was, you know, I am hell bent on continuing to stay at home with the kids. I don't care what it takes. I am going to make this work. This is going to happen. Like, we are running with this, and I am staying home with the kids. I don't care what happens. I don't care if I have to drill myself into the ground, work myself down into the core. Like, I am doing this. So that piece was always there. I always too, like, I think this is a huge piece of it too, is that I always had that confidence piece. You know, before I signed up, my husband was like, do you really think you're going to even be able to do this? Like, really? You think you're going to be able to get people? And I like looked him straight in the face, and I'm like, oh yeah, like I am doing this, and it is going to be great. I'm going to be awesome at it. So I never really lacked that confidence piece. And I really feel like that's huge in this business, is to have that confidence piece and then the belief, and then follow it up with the actions if you really want it to happen. So I had all that. So I was really lucky. Those are some of my strengths that I had right off the bat. So if you guys are struggling with your confidence right now, a good book that somebody recommended to me before was You Are a Badass by Jen Sincero. I don't know if you guys have heard of that, but I mean, it's so crucial to be able to have your confidence. Like, it has to be there. Otherwise, you're going to really struggle with this. So get that in check and get that all squared away. And check out that book if you haven't heard of it before. So You Are a Badass by Jen Sincero. And then what happened was, is, I mean, I wanted this really, really bad. So when I first signed up, I actually worked, I work all at night, you know, I don't work during the day when I'm with the kids, you know, I don't like looking back and having regrets. And I didn't want to look back and think to myself that, you know, I can't believe I quit my teaching career to stay at home with the kids, to have my face buried in the computer to work my Beachbody business. So I don't really do any Beachbody work during the day. When they go down for their naps, that's when I get my workout in. I'll do a couple of things around the house, and then maybe I can get in a little work then. But most of my work, all of it, is done at night when they go to bed, from like 8 o'clock on. And you know, guys, this is not easy for me. Trust me. I mean, I am exhausted at the end of the day with these kids. They're only 18 months apart. We're actually battling a stomach bug right now in the house. And like, seriously, my husband and my daughter and my son have been throwing up like all day for the past few days. I am determined not to get this. I'm tired. So, you know, I probably want to just go to sleep some of the nights, but I don't. So I started out actually originally just working. I worked a lot is what it boils down to. I mean, I started out doing 2.5 hours at night when the kids would go to bed. And then it became like, just like addicted to it. Like, I started to like really love it and just want to do it as much as I could. And actually it was really funny. Somehow my husband and I stumbled across Scotty's sacrifices video that he made. I don't even know how the heck we found it. And then my husband and I sat down and we watched it, and that was it. I was like, this is it. It's time to get serious, you know? And so at that point, my husband had kind of started to see that I was having like a lot of success with this, and he was totally on board with it now at this point. He had researched everything about the company and that like, this isn't a scam, like you can totally do well with this. And so we both sat down and had an agreement that, you know, we're going to make a lot of sacrifices right now, but it's going to be worth it in the long run. And so obviously I only get like probably 5 hours of sleep at night because I work now from like 8 to 12:30, sometimes 1 o'clock in the morning. And then my kids are up for the day at like 6 in the morning. So lots of E&E and lots of Shakeology and coffee over here. That's what'll get the job done. And we, you know, used to just hang out and just watch TV at night. You know, now we have one date night every Saturday night. But you know, he's okay with that. And I'm okay with that too, because we know it's just temporary. So I'm putting in a lot of time into this. You know, like I said, it's a good 4 to 5 hours a day. And that's how I was able to move so fast in this business. I started doing the 21-day fix. I lost all that weight too. I got into the best shape of my life. I got to the lowest weight I've ever been, and have never felt better. So when I reach out to people, honestly, I don't worry about bothering them. I don't feel like I'm bothering them. I really feel like I'm doing them a disservice by not telling them about either the programs or about this business opportunity now, because I've seen what it's done for me in so many different ways. So, you know, I don't get nervous when I message people. I basically talk to anybody and everybody. Yeah, the author of that book was Jen Sincero. There you go. So I talk to anybody and everybody. When people say, when they tell you guys, invite, I literally message like 40 plus people. Sometimes I will seriously message like 75 people, you know, occasionally at a time. But I mean, the numbers are up there, and I am very persistent. If you ask anybody one word to describe me, they will tell you it's persistent. You know, I talk to people. If I don't hear back from them, I always follow up 24 hours later, and I always help anybody no matter what. So even if somebody says no to me, I still help them and work with them, and I never take no for an answer. I always find out, you know, what's your reason for maybe not being interested? Is it a money concern? Is it a time concern? Maybe it's a confidence issue, and maybe I can help you. So I always find out those reasons. I don't just take no and then run away with my tail between my legs. I keep going. I don't get down. You know, I have a lot of, you know, family members and closer friends that kind of, you know, they think this is a joke and everything. And when they hear my goals and my dreams for this, they kind of laugh and they don't believe it. And I don't get upset by that at all. I really don't. To me, that just puts more fuel in my fire. And, you know, I just think in my head, oh, just you wait. Like, I can't wait for you to see really what's going to happen as time goes on and on. And actually today was like a huge milestone for me in this business, because I logged into my account, and this was the first week that my paycheck actually exceeded my husband's take-home paycheck. So we were like, yes, it's working, you know, like all these, you know, just a little bit every day, like over time, just stick with it and it's totally worth it. So that was like really huge for us. I'm just checking over my notes here real quick here. So yeah, so I literally spend like all my time, you know, just connecting with people. It's just all about talking to people, putting in more time, you know, believing in what you're doing, you know, being persistent and following up, like helping everybody no matter what. If somebody tells you no, it really doesn't mean like no, like I'm never going to do this. It just means like no, right now probably isn't the best time for me. But eventually, you know, when it comes time for them to want to start on their health and fitness journey, you know, you're going to be the first person that they're going to think of. You know, your name's going to pop up into their mind. So that's why, like, you know, you're planting seeds with all these people that you're talking to, you know, on a day-to-day basis. And then, you know, the support, like I said, from my husband was huge. I really feel like I probably would have had a hard time taking off this fast if he didn't support me, because, you know, like I said, you know, we're both busy all day long. I'm with the kids. He's working all day. And then at night, you know, that's our time that we could be spending together. And I've had a lot of coaches on my team, you know, tell me that, you know, they've actually kind of fallen off. A couple of my leaders actually have, because their husband, you know, or significant other hasn't been supporting of them. So my husband is like totally on board. He's like the business guy in this, you know. He loves, you know, checking out the downline. He must refresh that thing like 150 times a day. It's like crazy. So I bring in everybody. He hasn't been able to make one like sale or help anybody out yet. He's tried, but he just, you know, he can't do that. He struggles with that, but that's okay. So I reach out and bring everybody in, and I train the team. And then he kind of tells me where to place them, you know, to maximize out the, you know, the amount of money that I can make. So let me just jot over here real quick here for you guys, make sure I covered everything. And yeah, so, you know, I think though too, like I tell a lot of people now, you know, I didn't have a story from the past, like a really like traumatic, you know, any kind of story like that. I tell everybody, you know, if I didn't get into Beachbody and I looked back on my life, I would be able to honestly say that my life was really good. But, you know, then as I started doing this, I realized, okay, well, it's not about, you know, just good. Like, you know, this is your one life, you know, your one life is your one chance, you know, why not make this, you know, the best life possible for you and your family, you know, like really make this the best it can possibly be for you and your family. And it's so awesome knowing that with this business, you can totally do that. And I really did not believe in that at the beginning when I first signed up for this. I really didn't. I mean, I was just hoping to make, you know, a couple $100 to help, you know, offset the bills and whatnot, so I didn't have to go back. I had no idea that it could grow like this and that you could do this well. And then, you know, it's just awesome to think that if you stick with it and you know, you're driven and you have the big picture in your mind, you know, you need to have your why, you know, just dangling here the entire time, because there's going to be so many hard times, you know, and you're going to feel sick on some days and you're going to get headaches and there's going to be things thrown at you in life. And, you know, you're going to feel like maybe you want to stop, but if you keep that why and that main reason right here, you know, it will help drive you to it. And so that was my kids for me. I mean, there are so many times where I could have just been like, oh my gosh, like I can't do this, but you know, keeping them in the front of my mind this entire time really helped. You know, they were my reason for making this work. And now I have all kinds of things on the radar for them and for my family that, you know, I would have never been able to provide before if we hadn't done this. You know, like we're hoping that by the end of next summer, beginning of fall, we'll be able to retire my husband from his job. You know, we want to move to Hawaii in 2 years and we want to bring my parents to 67. And they've, you know, they've lived a tough life with, you know, lots of, you know, burden financially and just things like that. And they're just, it's just a lot of stress. And so I want to be able to give back to them and help them out and bring them with us. You know, college education, we would have never in a million years been able to even provide anything for that. But now with this, like, it's totally possible. And I think just really important is just the way that you look at things now. When you're in this business, it changes everything. And I heard that, like I said, at the beginning, and honestly, I didn't believe it. Like, I was just like, oh, please. Like, they're just all just saying that. Like, it doesn't really get, does really everything get better? But it really does. And it's just so awesome to think that I'm going to be able to pass that down, you know, to my kids and be able to teach them that it's important to go after, you know, something in life that you truly love and are excited about, that really something that you're passionate about. And so one of the things I tell everybody and I would tell you guys too is that, you know, you got to figure out if you're in this and you want it to just be a hobby, like if you really, really love what you're doing right now, if you work or whatever you're doing, if you really, truly love it and you wake up every single day and you are psyched to do it, then that's awesome. Then just keep doing what you're doing, you know, and this can be more of a hobby for you and that's fine. But if you're in the position where, you know, you really aren't 100% happy where you are and you don't want to stay where you are for the next, you know, God knows how many years until you're 55, 60 years old when you retire, then this is your chance to go out and actually change it and really create the life that you want for you and for your family. And the choice is yours. So it doesn't matter if you are brand new in this business. I mean, I'm only 10 months in. And you saw how fast, you know, I was able to move. So it doesn't matter if you're brand new now and this is your first day as a coach or if you've been doing this for a couple of years. I mean, every day is a new day and you can choose to, you know, pick up the pieces and pull yourself up by your bootstraps and run with this and make it what you want to make it. And that's the beauty of it being your own business. And so really, guys, I think that you really should just think about what you want your life to look like. You know, that's what I do now and like where you want this to take you and then just go for it. But definitely, you know, when you look at all the top coaches in the company, you know, they're no different than any of us. They're no different than me. They're no different than any of you guys. They're just people who are driven. You know, they are putting in the time, they are busting their butts for this. Then they have the long-term vision for it and they don't quit. And that's it. That's the only difference. So you guys are all capable and, you know, I'm capable. And so I just say, go after it, guys. Sorry, that was so long. I didn't even have an E&E. I chose not to have an E&E tonight because I talked on another call the other night, and I swear to God, I have a lot of energy as it is anyways, but I had the E&E the other night, and it just set me over the top, so I chose not to do that tonight.
Wow, well, that was impressive without E&E. Wait till y'all get to try the Energize, the new one. You guys, I think most of you guys saw my first video after I took Energize. I was talking like a million miles an hour. So no, Kathy, we really appreciate everything you shared with us. Do you have a few minutes to answer a couple questions?
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, of course.
I definitely have some questions, but I'm going to answer some on here. Amanda asked, because you were talking about it, this was at the point I remember you were talking about, you kind of felt like a disservice not telling somebody about Beachbody, the fitness, the business end. And she said, so you didn't wait for a reason to bring it up in a conversation. You just brought it up. Can you tell us how you would bring up Beachbody to somebody randomly?
Yeah. So, you know, like for example, if I was out, like I was out the other day and we were on the bike path with the kids, like going for a walk and everything. And, I had, you know, these two people that came riding by on their bicycles and they stopped next to us and they were like, oh, hey, you know, were you guys here the other day when we were running the half marathon? I think we saw you guys. And I'm like, oh yeah, like that was us. So they pulled over and started talking. And what happens is, you know, they start to ask like, you know, what I do, if I'm a stay-at-home mom. And before, at the very, very beginning, you know, I would just say I'm a stay-at-home mom, you know. I didn't say anything about Beachbody, but that only lasted like 2 weeks. And then I quickly changed that around. And I literally would just come out to them and just say like, yeah, I stay at home with the kids now. I'm a Beachbody coach. So I get to, actually I say like I'm a health and fitness coach most of the time. They say, oh, I'm a health and fitness coach. So I get to help people with their health and fitness goals every day, like all from home. It's awesome. It's so rewarding and it's so much fun. And then they're like, oh my gosh, really? I'd love to hear more about that. And so then I get their information and then I either, you know, set up a call to talk to them or I, you know, start chatting with them on Facebook or through email. But basically, you know, whenever anybody like gets together with me and asks me what I do or how things are going, like I always bring this up. Like I'll always tell them like, oh yeah, like my Beachbody business is going great, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I'll tell them a couple of things that have happened and that's all I do.
Awesome. Thank you. Another one of the questions was like, it kind of goes along with that. How do you invite, but this is particularly on like in instant messages or on Facebook.
Yeah.
How do you invite or how do you bring that up or what do you invite them to? Do you have them watch anything? Do you set up a call?
Yeah. So a lot of the times what I do, and this is what I did, especially at the beginning when these were all people that I like knew, you know, from like either high school or college or whatnot. So when I reached out to them, I would just reach out to them in a private message and it would say something like this, like, oh, hey, Jen, like, I hope everything's going great. I love seeing the pictures of your kids on Facebook. They are so adorable. How old are they now? Like, can't wait for the summer to get here. I love the warm weather. I just wanted to reach out to you and see if this is something you might want to be interested in. I'm going to be running a 21-day challenge on May 18th. It features a 21-day fix program. It combines 30-minute workouts with a portion control nutrition plan, and we're going to be pairing that with Shakeology. I have two spots left in my group. Do you think this is anything you'd want to join with me? Let me know and I'm happy to answer any questions you have. I always do that kind of thing. I always, ever since day one, like I always either give a deadline for when they need to, you know, sign up for this, or I give them a certain number of spots left. Because if you say, even if I have like unlimited spots, you know, it's just that if you don't do that, people tend to really like drag their feet forever. But if you kind of say that you have a couple spots left, did you want to grab one of them? Or tonight's the last night so that your things will come in on time. It takes 5 to 7 business days. If they hear something like that, then they're more likely to get like right back to you. I ask for referrals like all the time too from people that I've signed up. And I've been adding, you know, ever since day one, I add like 3 to 5 new friends every single day. So as soon as they accept my friend request, I make sure to go to their wall and I start liking some of the things that they post up. I start to comment on some of the things that they post. So that way they start to get to know me a little bit and then they can kind of start to see what I'm all about. I might even just reach out to them and just start talking to them about a picture that they posted up, like a recipe or even, you know, someone got flowers the other day from their husband. I reached out about that. And then that way it's not so awkward when I do start to talk about, you know, getting them into a challenge group now. I tend to focus a little bit more now on like reaching out about the business opportunity now. You know, for the first 6 months, it was more about like challenge groups. And now I'm trying to focus more on the business opportunity and getting active coaches.
Awesome. So I have a ton of notes here. Mine particularly were, so you had this feeling of like your heart was getting ripped out, right? And so that kind of forced you into it. Number two, or you're not a quitter. Prove people wrong. You're desperate to do whatever it takes. But I think those are all kind of attributes. As I listened to it, those are very similar to me in a way. Like, you know, when I got started, I felt like that. I remember the way that I felt, and when I remember wording it with one of my mentors, was like, I feel like I'm like at my job. My wife was at her job. I was at my job. I felt like I was drowning, like literally in bills and in work and not being able to get above or be able to catch up. And I felt literally like Beachbody was this hand reaching into the water. And I was going to grab onto that thing and I was not going to let go and have that pull me out. So that's kind of the mindset I had my first year as I went into it. So I love that. Another huge thing that I noticed in you that I want to point out is, I'll point it out to also, I see Tracy on here, but I know Tracy and Barton are together there. You said you had confidence. You said, I will be awesome at this. I remember Barton went diamond in about just over 2 months. And I met up with him in Salt Lake City when I was coming back from a cruise. And I remember sitting down with him by the pool. We just had a few minutes. He was on break. And he's like, you know what? No one can tell me I'm not awesome. I'm awesome. I'm going to do this thing. You know, so he had that confidence in that he's a great person and that, you know, he's awesome. And why not? Why wouldn't people want to be a part of this with him? So that's a huge key to success for everybody on here to look at. In Kathy just saying, hey, I'm going to do this. I'm awesome. You know, like I'm awesome. I'm going to do this. I have the confidence that I can do this. And, you know, that's kind of what Barton said. And, you know, I made a Facebook post the week I signed up that said, I'll have one of the greatest teams in Beachbody. And I had no team at that point whatsoever. And so it was that confidence that I went into this, not that confidence in putting that one post. So that's how I showed up every day was, I'm going to be great at this. We're going to be great. I'm going to attract in great people. And so with that focus, like on my purpose of bringing my wife home and your purpose of being the stay-at-home mom and having this income, having that purpose out in front, you just show up every day with that mindset and you're going to attract awesomeness in. You're going to attract great people in. But if you're one that's sitting back and saying, or you're sitting here like, oh, this, I'm so overwhelmed, or why are people telling me no? And those are the thoughts going through your head while you're doing these invites. You're going to get more of that. You're going to attract more of that into your life. So it's important that you have that confidence and that clear vision of where you're going. And that's what will make you do what Kathy did. You know, take those, and that's without sacrificing family time aside from with her husband, right?
Right.
Aside from the one date night a week. So, and I can relate very much to that because that's exactly how Gabby and I were as well. And some of you guys are new on here, so I'll tell you guys, I had the same experience with my wife. I said, hey, do you believe I can do this when I signed up? I signed up without telling her. She knew I was thinking about it. And I signed up and I went home and I said, do you believe I can do this? And she said, I don't know about that, but I believe in you. So all I needed was that belief that somebody else believed in me. Because I already had that belief in myself, finally, that I could do it. And have that extra belief in me meant all the world to me. So I want you guys to know, every single one of you guys on here, that I believe in you guys. Like, same like Kathy said, we're all the same. We're all created with the same potential. We all have different talents and abilities. But if we grow and focus on building those talents, you'll connect with other people with amazing talents that'll come into your life as well. If anybody else has any questions, feel free to ask them real quick. I have a question as well, because heck, I haven't done many of those things that fast as you have in your business. So diamond in like 11 days and 2-star, what was it? 56 days.
Yeah.
Tell me how you go. What did you tell these brand new coaches that helped them go to diamond within, obviously they had to have gone diamond in less than 60 days from their setup. So what was your conversation like to them? What kind of initiative did they take? What kind of personality were they? What traits did they have that made them do that?
Well, honestly, one of the stars was my husband's account that I grew to diamond. So, you know, that doesn't really count.
That counts.
So I did that twice. And then another one was my other coach, Daryl, who before I even signed up, you know how I said that I had kind of been dragging my feet for like 3 months before actually doing this. I had kind of had her in the back of my mind the entire time because she was the one who had originally recommended P90X to me 6 years ago and got me into it. And she had, you know, I went to college with her and she had always been into like health and fitness, and she loves motivating others and things like that. So I kind of started like planting the seeds with her in her head, and I would, you know, tell her like, Daryl, I'm going to become a Beachbody coach, and you're going to do it too, and we're going to be awesome, and we're going to hop on this crazy train, and we're going to go to the top, and it's going to be great. And I didn't know what the heck I was talking about. And I mean, I'm not even anywhere where I want to be right now, but I still was saying all these crazy things. And so when I signed up, she signed up right away with me. Like, you know, I signed up, and then like 3 days later, I met her at a restaurant, and I talked to her a little bit about it, and I got her signed up, and she was really motivated right away. And, you know, she signed her husband up, got him the Emerald. She found another girl right off the bat that could get to Emerald. So that's how I did that so fast. So it was really just that one coach, you know?
Yeah. Awesome. So thanks for sharing that with us. I want to see if there's any other questions here before I close this out. Erica, but you have to feel what you're saying. Yeah, that makes sense. So yeah, it's important. I believe it's important that you get to the point, like we talk about the three vital behaviors all the time. And one thing that Kathy said is she felt she needed to tell everybody about this, whether it was the fitness side or the business side. And that's honestly how I feel as well. That everybody, I have to tell everybody about that. But it's because I've gotten to a point, and I got to that point the day I signed up, you know, that I felt honestly that anybody that became a Beachbody coach, whether it was for finances or bettering their health or being surrounded by positive people or growing as a person, whatever it is that they told me they wanted, that they could achieve that and better their lives as a Beachbody coach. You know, they don't have to be a million-dollar earner, a top coach, a six-figure earning coach, a full-time coach. Just anybody that plugs in and does the three vital behaviors, their life will completely be 100% better in a year if they did those three vital behaviors over the course of the year. I feel that 100% in my heart, so I am not afraid to tell somebody about that and that they should become a coach. And it, kind of like what you shared as well. So, Erica, you've got to – you have to feel that inside, you know, the things that you're sharing with people, you have to believe it 100% yourself that it will improve their life as well. But just like Kathy shared, I had no proof whatsoever that we could have the best team in the world, right? Where we could have all of you guys as a part. I didn't know any of you guys. I'm looking at this car now. I didn't know a single one of these that I can see on here. Of the coaches that I could see on the video, I didn't know a single one of you guys before I began this journey. Not one of you guys. So it just shows you what can happen when you have that confidence in belief. And then you put in the hustle, like Kathy talks about, you fall in love with the process and you just reach out to people and you ask for referrals. And you know, if someone's like, I don't, you know, not for me, Kathy's like, do you know anybody that could benefit from a 21-day fitness program? Just being willing to go out there and get yourself out there like that. So, Kathy, we appreciate you so much for coming on and sharing with us. Before I let you go, does anybody have another question you want to ask Kathy or anybody on this team that you want to get out there? You can just unmute yourself and ask if you have one.
I have one, Kathy.
Okay, hi.
Barton always has a question. What do you use for, so on your challenges, where do you get the comments or content? Do you create it yourself or are you just using the already created
content? Actually it's funny because when I first did this, I didn't know that they had like a whole template and whatnot that you could follow in the Coach Online office. So I literally was, you know, that first one or two challenge groups, I actually was just like making it up all myself, just like kind of winging it, trying to motivate these people. And then when I found out that they had, you know, like a whole template and all that stuff to follow, I pretty much stick to that as much as I can. I'll change around like some of the wording, you know what I mean, in a lot of the posts if it doesn't sound like me, you know, just to make it sound like it's me talking. But I tend to follow that a lot more. Now it tends to be a lot of my coaches running the challenge groups, and so they're kind of in charge of all that. But we usually follow that template in the Coach Online office.
Awesome. And personalize it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
There's a question on here from Samantha. Have you ever been in Facebook jail? Is there, can you put too much in your first message? Like if you're writing somebody for the first time, do you make it small? Do you put a ton of info? What do you put?
No, I mean, I don't put too much. You know, when I'm first reaching out to them, it's just that that basic message. I'll do a couple of them. Like sometimes I'll just reach out and I'll just say, you know, ask them how they're doing and connect with them some way on a personal level, and then kind of let them know that if they need any help with their health and fitness, you know, I'm here to help them. Always feel free to reach out. I run free clean eating groups if you'd like. I have a 21-day challenge group coming up that I could put you in if you'd like to join that. Just reach out and let me know what your goals are. So I'll do that a lot. But then most of the time I do use that one message about, you know, do you want to join my 21-day challenge group? And honestly, I mean, I've had like hundreds of people sign up, and that's been the most popular one. Everyone wants to do it because it's 21 days. Well, first of all, I've had like the most success with that one, so I can speak to it a lot. And so like everyone wants to do it because it's only 21 days. It doesn't matter if you've never worked out before or if you've been, you know, into fitness your entire life, you can still do it, and it can still be challenging, and you can see great results, and it's only 21 days. So, I will reach out with that same message. I mean, I can share it with you guys later and send it over to, you know, Scotty so he can give it to you guys, but I give it to all my coaches like as a template, to use. And I have a couple other scripts too, but that's been the one that's really worked the best for me, is with the 21-day fix. Unless I know someone is like really, really into fitness and they would benefit more from like a max 30 type of thing, then I'll talk more about those other programs. But yeah, the majority of the time I do use just that one basic invite to the 21-day fix. I don't go into like all the different food groups and all that, because then it is too long and people see this huge message pop up and then it's kind of like, whoa, what is this?
So I start as well, probably 95% of people on 21-day fix as well. So, yes, if you could send me over that template, I'll just put it in our team page for these guys. That would be awesome.
No problem.
I have one last question. So there was some specific, I'm a note taker. There's some specific words that you said. It was specifically, I spent all my time connecting with people, right? So. Yeah. What percentage of your time would you say, because you're growing a team, you're star diamond, 4-star diamond coach, second, 2-star qualifying in your second. So what percentage of your time do you spend, I hate this word, but managing or running groups versus connecting with brand new people and inviting people to join your challenge or join your business as a coach? What's your time?
Split. I spend very little time now managing like, you know, the challenge groups and things like that. Like my free clean eating group and stuff like that, that's all like uploaded by Hootsuite and stuff like that. I have most of my coaches doing the challenge groups. So I literally spend all my time now. Like I said, it's all at night, so my time is limited, but I spend all of my time now doing, you know, one-on-one calls with my coaches, doing business opportunity calls with new people who are interested in it, doing my team call. I have a training call that I just, you know, had 2 of my coaches now running those calls. And then I spend like, literally it's like 90% of my time, like reaching out to new people and trying to figure out like, you know, what their goals are in life and if they're happy where they are. And if this might be something that they want to do. I don't spend a lot of time. Like I have a website and everything, you know, my husband's in charge of all that. You know, he kind of like, you know, he's built the whole thing and it's great. I haven't really picked up anybody yet through that. Same thing with my like page. I've had like a couple people come through that, but it's literally been through all of my private messages to people, which is what I do like 90% of the time.
So if you're a newer coach or you felt kind of stuck, there's some great advice. She's spending the majority of her time connecting with people, with brand new people. You know, even with a team as large as we're at, I looked at today, we're at 28,000 coaches in our team now. And I spend a good 70% of my time inviting people, building relationships with brand new people, reaching out to brand new people, and connecting people, you know, in that aspect, getting on the phone with prospects, inviting them, listening to them, finding out what they need, and then giving them the tools to achieve their goals. And you know, I do that as well. Yes, I have goals I've set. I'll never miss Success Club 10 because I want to always be that example. I never just want to write off the coattails or success of the past 4 years. I want to continually be the example that if you guys follow what I'm doing on social media with inviting people, that you guys can create success in your businesses as well. So make sure that you're spending the majority. If you're newer and you're like, what do I do? It's not spending all your time watching training videos. It's practicing connecting with people and building relationships with people and inviting them to be a part of this journey with you. You'll figure out the stuff as you go. Just like Kathy said, she, the first couple of challenge groups, she didn't even know there was a challenge group guide she could follow, but she just got people started on their programs, you know, so they can start seeing results with it. And that's what we're about. That's what Carl emphasizes. Like every time I hear him talk, get people results, you know, with our fitness program. So make sure that that's our focus as we do that moving forward. So the question, I better cut us off before we keep getting more questions and keep you all night, Kathy.
It's okay. I'm up until 1 a.m. over here. So, you know, I got 3 more hours.
There you go. What's your normal turnaround from when you meet someone new before you invite them when doing it online? I'm guilty of waiting way too long to invite them. So when you meet somebody online on your page, maybe they liked one of your posts.
Yeah.
Or a new friend you reached out to. How long before you invite them to do something?
I wait like a month. And honestly, like I really, you know, sometimes it's a little bit before that. It depends what I see them posting online themselves. You know, if they post something that, you know, that they're looking to lose weight, a lot of times people post about that. Like I need to get ready for summer. Then I'll reach out to them because, you know, like I said, people are sitting around, you know, waiting for us to come and talk to them and help them. You know, a lot of people don't know where to go or what to do. And so that's what you're for. So don't wait too long because people need you.
I love that. People need you. So I love that. So we'll end this call. You've added a ton of value to us, so I want you to know that. I know we're going to see you as an elite and a top coach in this company, so keep driving forward with that. And we're going to remember this call and apply what you've taught us because we want to make sure that we value your time as well. But I can tell you one thing. Another thing that I see in you and all these things that you said about how you felt, why you did this, which are more important than any technical training you could give us, you know, understanding why you did it. That's what I always want to learn about somebody that's successful is why. What about you made you do this? Because the tools are all the same. One thing I can notice as you speak to us is that confidence. I can tell you're excited about it. I can tell you love that. You love what you do. And so us as coaches, we can look at that and be like, when we talk to somebody, are we excited? Do we sound excited about it? Do we believe in it as much as Kathy believes in it? Because that's what that prospect or that person is going to be feeling, you know? So we've got to think about that when we're talking. Are we monotone? Are we maybe coming across monotone? Even though we believe in it, are we not showing our excitement towards it, you know? And really working on our ability to create that type of excitement, that type of passion, that type of belief so that people can be motivated to move, just like I'm motivated to move after listening to Kathy share everything with us today. So anyhow, I have this recorded. So once again, Kathy, we really do appreciate you being on with us. And this will be recorded. And I'll look forward to getting that. I wrote a note here, but I'll look forward to getting that from you.
Awesome.
In the inbox so I can upload it for the team. So
thank you guys so much. Seriously, thank you for letting me speak to you all. And you guys have an awesome coach. I'm sure you guys know that.
Thank you. Each one of us is amazing, right, guys? Thumbs up if you're amazing. That's what I like. I want to see all those thumbs. There you go. Okay, we'll see you guys later.